Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today we will discuss the renal necrosis. So there is normal kidney grass and microscopy, clinical summary, autopsy findings on image, virtual microscopy, study question and next case. So before going through this video, please watch previous video on types of necrosis. Now first of all we will see the cut section of the kidney. Normal kidney is beautiful on cut section. It has nice outer cortex, medulla, renal pelvis and attached ureter. There is no focal defect. There is homogeneous color and this is the microscopic appearance of the normal kidney. There are renal corpuscles with glomeruli and there is a capsule and tubules all with blue nuclei. Now clinically a patient presented with 70 years old patient, known case of arterial fibrillation, presented with renal failure and died. Because renal arterial fibrillation is source of thromboemboli, so it causes an autopsy, there is renal infarct. So you can see the wedge shape or triangular area, solid area of whitish yellow pale in color. Its base is towards the capsule and the apex is towards the corticomedullary junction. Now it is due to ischemia, but some toxin can cause also renal infarction. A 48 year old male committed suicide by ingesting an unidentified toxin, and on autopsy there is renal infarction. So the commonest cause is arterial blockage, and uncommon some toxin may cause renal infarction. Now the point to remember on gross examination of the kidney, these may be you may called points of identification. Focal wedge shape area yellow white in color, sharply delineated, basis towards capsule and apex towards corticomedullary junction. Now the kidney may have multiple infarcts, but you can appreciate they have same wedge shape configuration, base towards the capsule cortex and apex towards the corticomedullary junction. Now another scenario, a 70 year old man with chest pain and shortness of breath and diagnosed as massive cardiac infarction developed renal failure. Because massive cardiac infarction lead to cardiogenic shock and hypotension, and autopsy finding revealed diffuse cortical necrosis. You can see patchy cortical necrosis on the this specimen. So microscopically there is coagulative necrosis. You can appreciate the pink area of dead tissue surrounded by basophilic normal tissue. The ghosty outline is preserved because of denaturation of proteins. Their outline of cell is preserved. Then there is inflammatory zone and viable tissue. Because it occurs in living tissue, so it is living tissue respond by inflammation. So normal you can see nice nuclei, and on the necrosed there is ghosty appearance and there is no nuclei in the cell. So on microscopy there is preservation of the architecture, ghost-like appearance. This is the most important feature. There is eosinophilia, loss of nuclei and inflammation, because inflammation is always present in necrosis. So diagnosis is based upon the gross microscopic features and the clinical scenario. The clinical scenario points towards the arterial occlusion in the first case, and the most likely diagnosis is coagulative necrosis of the kidney. So points to remember are, the information is given in clinical scenario, points toward the thromboembolism of the renal vessels, kidney solid organ, ischemia is cause of coagulation necrosis in solid organs, morphologically infarct is pale in color, microscopically outline of normal architecture is preserved, most important criteria is eosinophilia and loss of nuclei. Now this you can search for the answer of these questions. Why it is pale, the infarct is pale, and why the shape is triangular or wedge shape. Now we should remember this short dua, A'udhu bi kalimatillahi tammati min sharri ma khalaq. And you can watch next video on caseous necrosis. This video is produced by Pakistan Homeschool channel. It is a YouTube channel. You can go there and watch other videos as well.